Ludu Daw Amar. Ludu Daw Amar, also Ludu Daw Amar, Burmese Luthud. Amma, pronounced Ludu Daw, at Ma 29 November 1915, 7 April 2008, was a well-known and respected leading dissident writer and journalist in Mandalay, Burma. She was married to fellow writer and journalist Ludu U Hla and was the mother of popular writer Nyi Pu Lay. She is best known for her outspoken anti-government views and radical left-wing journalism, besides her outstanding work on traditional Burmese arts, theater, dance and music, and several works of translation from English, both fiction and non-fiction. Student writer and activist. Born into an old established Mandalay family that traded in tobacco and manufactured cheroots, Amar was the fourth in a family of 12, of whom only 6 survived to adulthood. She was educated at the American Baptist Mission School and subsequently the National High School under the headmaster Abdul Razak, who later became the education minister in Aung San's cabinet and was assassinated with him and Man. She read science at the Mandalay Intermediate College and went on to Rangoon University for a bachelor's degree. Her first notable work was a translation of Trials in Burma by Morris Collis in 1938, and by that time she was already published in the university's OAAUE, Peacock's Call magazine, and also Kipuyek Roman II, PREMGGJNG, Progress magazine run by her future husband U Hla under her own name, as well as when the second university student strike in history broke out in 1936. Amar and her friend from Mandalay M. A. Ma'on became famous as women student leaders among the strikers camped out on the terraces of the S.H. Wedagon Pagoda. U Hla was a staunch supporter of the strike and started courting Amar. In 1939 they got married, and U Hla moved his magazine to Mandalay. Wartime Kipuye. The family fled to the countryside north of Mandalay when the Second World War broke out in the East in 1942, but the magazine continued to come out. Daw Amar translated one of the 3 wartime bestsellers of the Japanese soldier writer Hino Ashie called Wheat and Soldiers Gunn in GCC Sa, Jion H. Nitsitha, and published it together with the other 2 translated by her husband. She also translated The Rainbow Escape T.T.N. Riang, Fetent Yang by the Czechoslovak writer Wanda Wasalska in 1945, printed on blue matchbox wrapping paper, the only kind of paper available at the time. Both husband and wife became involved in the resistance movement against the Japanese occupation and formed the ʔshā Luangjr, Lanji, Asia Youth Organization in Mandalay. Her husband was arrested briefly by the military authorities after the recapture of the city by the British 14th Army on account of the Hino Ashihe books. Postwar Ludu. At the end of the war in 1945, U Hla launched a fortnightly paper called the Ludu Journal Luthug. Ani, Ludu is Burmese for the people/masses, with Amar as his assistant editor. The Ludu Daily was successfully launched the following year, and the couple subsequently came to be known as Ludu U Hla and Ludu Daw Amar. Their incisive political commentaries and analyses made a significant contribution to the country's yearning for independence and unified struggle against colonial rule. Their publications had never carried advertisements for alcohol, drugs to enhance sexual performance or gambling, nor racing tips, salacious affairs and gossip. U Hla had to be persuaded to make an exception of film advertisements for the survival of the paper. One morning in 1948, soon after Burma gained her independence from Britain, however, the Kipuye press in Mandalay was dynamited to rubble by government troops, who were angry that the Ludu couple appeared to be sympathetic to the communists. This was a time when regime change happened quite often, with the city falling into the hands, in turn, of the Karen rebels, communists, and the new socialist government under UNU. The entire family, including 2 pregnant women, was thrown out into the street, lined up, and was about to be gunned down when a number of monks and locals successfully intervened to save their lives. In 1953, Amar traveled abroad to the World Democratic Women's Conference in Copenhagen, World Peace Conference in Budapest, and Fourth World Festival of Youth and Students in Bucharest. In October 1953, the Anti-Fascist People's Freedom League AFPHL government of UNU imprisoned U Hla under Section 5 for sedition as a political prisoner after publishing a controversial news story in. They had five children by now, with the youngest Nyin Chan. His given name means peace in Burmese, pseudonym Nyi Pu Lay B, 1952, barely a toddler. In March 1959, the paper was sealed off by the authorities, and it did not come out again until May the next year. Amar traveled to Moscow in 1962 as an invited guest by Aeroflot Russian Airlines and visited East Germany, Czechoslovakia, and China. U Hla and Daw Amar were well known to foreign students of Burmese as well as Burmese writers, journalists, and artists. The younger generation of budding writers and artists called them U Hla Uncle and Daw Daw Auntie. Their home, Ludu Take Ludu House on 84th and 33rd, and always open to such visitors, was often their first port of call in Mandalay. Military era. The Ludu Daily was closed down by the military government on July 7, 1967. The paper had openly championed for peace and a socialist society and came out very strongly in support of the peace parley in 1963 between the Revolutionary Council government of Nyi Win and various insurgent groups, both communist and ethnic, just as they had done before in the early years of the Civil War in the 1950s. When the peace talks broke down, Amar's oldest son, Sowin B, 1941, aged 22, and a student leader at Rangoon University, went underground with a few others to join the Communist Party of Burma. He was killed in a bloody purge in 1967 in the jungles of Bago Yoma Mountains when the CPB carried out its own cultural revolution. The Ludu couple, true to Burmese Buddhist attitude to death, declined an invitation from the authorities to visit their firstborn's jungle grave. Their second son, Pothen Jayong V, 1945, was also arrested for alleged clandestine student political activities at Mandalay University in July 1966, aged 21, and detained without charge or trial until May 1972. He spent part of his imprisonment in Mandalay prison and later on Cocos Island penal colony in the Andaman Sea. They were personally known to Nyi Win from the early days, and the latter often called at their place whenever he visited Mandalay. They carried on with writing, researching, organizing literary seminars, giving talks and publishing material other than domestic politics, and remained active in social and community affairs. In 1975, they accepted the government's invitation to give talks to university students from both Mandalay and Rangoon, taking part in the reconstruction of the temples in Bagan damaged by the great earthquake of Amar was given the epithet Tough by name. Tough by nature by some people, Amar means tough slash hardy in Burmese. Publications. Daw Amar had written several books, including biographies, travelogues, treatises on traditional Burmese culture, and numerous articles in various magazines, some of them autobiographical and many collected into books later. Femana Ho Chi Minh, President Ho Chi Minh, 1950. H. Socialist Tank BMYA though to the Socialist Lands 1963. Thithu Chit Thaw Anapiania, the Mia Artists That People Loved 1964. It won the National Award for Literature on Burmese Culture and Arts in the same year. Ombala, Po Sain, Sain Gedown Theatre Performers of the Same Names 1967. SHWEO, Bagale Artists of the Same Names in Two Volumes 1969. S.H. Women Tin Mong Theater Performer of the Same Name 1970. Anyant Traditional Open Air Performance in Two Volumes 1973. Gaba Aki Zaun Sa Out the World's Biggest Book 1973 English Translation by Dr. Than Tun 1974. S.H. Wedding Tong Articles 1975 Translated into Japanese by Yasuko Dobashi Aki Yin Yin MYA 1994. Sayaj Thakin Kodaw H. Meng, a biography of Thakin Kodaw H. Meng, 1976. Chindwin HMA Pinal Lo, From the Chindwin to the Sea, a Travelogue, 1985. Byanma Mahajita Burmese Classical Music, 1989. Salek Nilatha Tobacco and Man, co-authored with U Hla Daw Amar, smoked from 8 years of age till her 40s. Mandalay Thu Mandalatha MYA Mandalayans, 1991. Yadanabin Mandalay Mandalay, Kayamadu Mandalay Mandalay, Our Mandalay, 1993. Thathana Dezon Sayadaji MYA, The Royal Teachers Buddhist Abbots, The Light of Sasana, 1994. Kayamadu Ngiangji Ga, When We Were Young, 1994. Tong Leilaun HMA Nakyan Adi Amateya Amasaga, From Tong Leilaun to Nakyan, Words to Remember. To Remember. Remember. Gaba Akizan Kayak Sinju Daw, The World's Biggest Stone Image, 1996. Myanma Hkithit Baji Modern Burmese Art, 1997. Amy Shaysaga Mother's Words of Old in 2 Volumes, 1997. Vol. 3, 2007. Chisthaun Hnit Chisthaungun, 83 years, 83 words, 1998. Tong Lashabed and Bok MYA Windows on South Asia, 1990. Ng Ga Kayandit H. Kinpung, Though My Husband, My Young Love, 2001. HSC Hnepwe Zaid Hnit Kayamadu Enia, The 12 Season Festival Traders and Our Upcountry, 2002. Elwan Thu Sa Nostalgia, 2003. Sa Ak Sangal Luin Lutwit Atway Amin H. Somba MYA Customers in a Bookstore, Musings, 2004. MYA Miantzu Short Stories, 2006. Translated works from English include Trials in Burma by Morris Collies in 2 volumes, 1938. Sandamala by Morris Collies, 1940. Weak Ant Soldiers by Hino Ashihe, 1945. The Rainbow by Wanda Wasalska, 1945. The Challenge of Red China by Gunther Stein in 2 volumes, 1949. In the Name of Peace by Archie Johnstone, 1953. Listen Yankees by C. Wright Mills, 1963. Cash and Violence in Laos by Anna Louise Strong, 1963. The Other Side of the River by Edgar Snow, 1966. Memoirs of China in Revolution by Chester Ronning, 1979. African Short Stories, 1989. Thai Short Stories in 2 volumes, 1992-1993. Magazine articles. Kayamaye Thamia Thurbal Ludu U Hla, My Profile on the Life of Ludu U Hla in SHWE Amute. Famous Dissident. Daw Amar had been very outspoken against the military regime, particularly in her later years. She was arrested together with her husband and their youngest son, Naeem Chan, in 1978, after her second son, Pothin Jayong, went underground to join the Communist Party of Burma, current spokesman for the CPB, just like his late brother Sowin before him in 1963. Daw Amar and Naeem Chan were not released for more than a year from prison until later in 1979, after U Hla had been released. Naeem Chan was rearrested in December 1989, this time to spend nearly 10 years in prison. Pothin Jayong, now living in exile in Yunnan, would never see his mother again. U Hla died in 1982, after 43 years of marriage, 5 children and 6 grandchildren. The Ludu couple had been one of the best-known husband and wife teams among the Burmese literati. Daw Amar suffered another loss when her printing plants and warehouses burnt down in the Great Fire of 1984 that wiped out the heart of Mandalay. Since she turned 70 in 1985, Daw Amar's birthday had been celebrated by the world of art and literature in Burma every year. The event had become an unofficial convention of dissidents under the watchful eyes of the ever-present military intelligence service, normally taking place at Tong Leilon Monastery by the shores of Tongthaman Lake in Amarapura near Mandalay, until November 2006, when the venue had to be changed under pressure from the authorities. She remained active in public life and was instrumental in founding the Byamazo Lumaye Athin Mutual Voluntary Aid Association in 1998, engaged in helping poor families with the cost of healthcare and funeral error. She had been called mother of the people and grand old lady. In a society where old age is revered, most people would address her as a my mother the same as she would refer to herself according to Burmese custom. For those of us who don't dance to the tune of the authorities, we must be creative in what we write to get our message across, she said, confirming that there was no freedom of press in Burma. She regretted that she had to give up journalism and could only write about tradition and culture. In her articles collected later into Mother's Words of Old, she bemoaned the loosening of social cohesion, morals, and traditional values in dress and manner, which she blamed on economic disorder, consumerism and globalization, and Chinese immigration. She once wrote that the Chinese had occupied Mandalay without firing a shot, and had dubbed the present Lopan boss in Chinese era. She felt as if Mandalay was an undeclared colony of Yunnan province. Daw Amar was a staunch defender of Burmese history, culture, religion, and sovereignty embodied in her birthplace, the last royal capital of Burma. Mandalay, thus broadly nationalistic, religious, and ethnocentric traditionalist in her perspective, and yet she had been in the forefront of modernizing the written language, fostering mutual understanding and friendship between. Ludu Daw Amar died on 7 April 2008 at the age of 92. Her home was Ludu Take in Mandalay with her second daughter Tin in 1947, in charge of the publishing business, and her youngest. Her oldest daughter, then Yin Mar, B, 1943, a retired professor of medicine, who has also started writing, assuming one of her mother's old noms de plume, Mye Nint Zu, looked after her health. She was survived by her two sons, two daughters, and six grandchildren.